All stations, this is Mission Director on IM-1. We're evaluating how we can refine that signal and dial in the pointing for our dishes. What we can confirm, without a doubt, is our equipment is on the surface of the moon, and we are transmitting. So, congratulations, IM team. We'll see how much more we can get from that.
An excellent call from our mission director,
MD
Dr.
Prime
Tim Crane.
On, IM-1.
And over
Go
to our
Prime.
CEO, Steve Altus.
Yeah, if I could just pass on a few words to the entire team in Intuitive Machines at SuperBab and here in the Mission Control. What an outstanding effort. I know this was a nail biter, but we are on the surface and we are transmitting. And welcome to the moon.
Houston, Odysseus has found his new home.
An excellent call, and this is our team of Intuitive Machines mechanics and their families, their friends, everyone who has sacrificed so much to make it this far.
Really historic words. Welcome to the moon. Odysseus has found a new home. William, when you heard that, give us your reaction.
This is a big beginning. You know, it was a shame. We've seen so many control rooms explode into laughter and applause, and these men who had worked for and women who had worked for years to make their mission possibility land, and they're filled with the joy of this. This worked. We're doing something that has never been done before. Here, there's a small group, some desultory applause we landed, but it's huge. This is a huge event. How many nations, count them, landed or attempted to land on the moon and failed? We were possibly failing, but through a series of technological advancement, and also, I'm sorry to say it, a great deal of human luck, which should be important to note because luck has many aspects. I was thrilled with the fact that this beginning is a success.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. Once I heard the applause, it was so exciting. All of us were thrilled to hear that because we knew that would be the first really official sign that things were moving in the right direction despite this last minute problem that developed. The exact wording, and I just want to make sure we have that exact wording. Mm-hmm. Our equipment is on the surface of the moon. So when will we really know and get pictures of all of that and the details?
So we should get the first pictures 30 minutes after landing. And that'll be a picture that was taken by the lunar lander itself. And then if everything goes according to plan, if all of the equipment is functioning and intact, between an hour and 3 hours after landing is when Intuitive Machines has said that we will get the first picture of the lunar lander on the moon. And the way they did that was they actually had a little pop-off piece of technology, a little piece that was on the spacecraft that pops off so that when Odysseus was landing, it was able to get a shot of Odysseus, you know, with the moon in the background. So that would be even better confirmation for what exact kind of shape this lunar lander is in. You're right, it's important to point out the language that they used. Our equipment is on the surface of the moon. Of course, there are still questions about what kinds of condition it's in, given their communication issues, given the issues that they had with that navigation system. But the fact that you have the CEO of Intuitive Machines coming out and saying, you know, Odysseus has a new home, you have the control room down in Houston, Texas applauding. I think there's a certain degree of confidence that this mission has been a success, but of course, there are some questions. And like I mentioned before, Japan's Moon Sniper, it was dubbed a success in terms of the fact that it made a soft landing, but then it did tip over. So there's questions about that with Odysseus as well.
I want to bring back the former astronaut, Mae Jemison. Give me your final thoughts on what has just happened, a truly historic moment, Mae.
Well, it's really exciting because it shows the ingenuity and what it means to be able to connect technologies through. So that's really exciting. And to me, it's a series, one of a series of steps that we're going to be doing that's going to establish us on the moon to stay. But I also think it becomes one of those series of steps that helps us look back at ourselves. Who has the right to be on the moon? Who gets to participate? What do we do with it? How does it become a part of our greater world here as humans, as Earthlings? And so I think it's one of these really wonderful steps where the knowledge blended together, where, yes, luck was a part of it, but also it was about knowing what you're doing and being able to move forward. So I'm very excited about this as an evolutionary steps, not only for the U.S., but for the world in general.